Hello, in this video you will learn about security issues in the cloud computing. As you can see in unit 2 we have security in the cloud computing environment, then we have infrastructure security, and in infrastructure security we have network level security, host level security, application level security, data security and storage. So we are going to talk about security. So first we will see different ways to interact with data and applications. So we have different types of client that can link to cloud. First is mobile client, thin client and thick client. So one by one let's see what is mobile client. Mobile clients run from smartphones like iPhone or BlackBerry and PDAs. PDA means personal digital assistant. So mobile clients gain access the cloud services using smartphones or PDAs. Mobile clients have security and speed issues. As you know, they will connect to the cloud from the different locations, so there is no optimized connection, and due to this they face security and speed issues. Done. Second is thin client. Thin clients means client computer that have no hard drives or no DVD drives. So thin client simply display what's going on the screen, and best option if the client just want to access the cloud-based services and virtualized server, then client computers like thin client is best option, and they are also less expensive as compared to thick client. Done. So in case of thin client, there is no hard drives, there is no DVD ROM drives, so what's going on the screen they can display, and less expensive as compared to thick client. Let's see what is thick client. Thick client, also known as fat client or heavy client. These systems can be connected to server without network connection, and in case of thick client, applications are installed on the end user machines. As you know, applications are installed on the machine, so there is security issue, and if user want to maintain all the data files on their machine, then thick client is best option. And as I told you, thick clients are at risk to attack as compared to thin client, since the data is stored on the machine's hard drive, so there is security issue as compared to thin clients. So we have three types of client. In mobile client, they can access the cloud services using smartphone PDAs, but there is a security and the speed issues as they will connect to cloud from the different locations, so there is no optimized connection. Thin client means client computers that have no hard drive, no DVD ROM, and they can just display what's going on the screen, and if you want to just access the cloud-based services, virtualized servers, then this is the best option, and it is also less expensive as compared to thick client. Thick client means fat client or heavy client. In this case, applications are installed on the end user machine, so if you want to maintain the files on your machine, then this one is the good option for you, but this is not secure as data is stored on the machine hard drive, so there is risk. Next is security issue. Security is the number one issue in the cloud computing. Why? Because third parties can store your data without your permission, and even you don't know what's going on with your data, so that's why security is the number one issue in the cloud computing, because anybody can access your data without your permission, and you even don't know what's going on with it. Next is data leakage. We have solution for data leakage is centralization of data. As before we discussed thin and thick client, in case of thin client, they create a better change for centralization of data. Centralization also provide better monitoring, as it is centralized, so data is on one place, so it is easy to manage, check to see everything is okay or not. And in this case, as in you can see, in case of thick client, they download the files, applications on the machine, hard drive. So there is a risk in case of thin client, there is no hard drive. So data is centralized and there is no chances of data leakage in case of thin client. Next is question. Okay, over offloading work. Now, first question is here, can your organization provide 24/7 IT security staff? Yes or no? Obviously no, because that's too much expensive. And now we have solution for this technology is benefit. Here, cloud service provider will provide a secure environment for the end users. Done. So you have to do nothing. Everything is managed by her cloud service provider, and your data, important information, and everything that is related to you is their responsibility, and they provide more security to the end users. So it's very rare that your organization can provide 24/7 IT security staff. But in case of cloud service providers, it's their responsibility to provide a secure environment for the end users. You have to do nothing. Now, next question is why cloud service provider will provide security? So there is money in the pocket. Done. Many clients are paying for security. You know, many clients are paying for the security. They need security. And plus, cloud service provider want to maintain their reputation. So that's why they will provide the secure environment for the end users. Done. Next is forensics. It means if there is any breach. Breach means an act of breaking. So if there is any breach in case of cloud service provider, they can respond it quickly. But in case of another organization like us, we have to investigate the breach locally and it can take time. But in case of cloud service provider, they can respond it quickly and they can fix it. So how to build forensic servers? They are easy to build online. It costs nothing and until it comes into use. Done. Now we have security issues that software as a service providers face. So they face security issues like here, we are providing softwares as a service to the end users. So we need a secure network for the end users, secure hardware for the end users, secure application and data. User sensitive data should be protected. So we need here encryption. So it should be encrypted, that is user identity and their information. So we need to identify where the data is located. So these are the some issues. You can see these are the issues that software as a service provider face. Next is web application breaches. So you know, cloud service providers use many web applications. So this would be asked about the security of the web applications. So in case if you are dealing with the cloud service provider, so please seek out those who are willing to talk about how they are handling breaches. Done. And where their data is stored, because they are using, you know, many web applications. So if the cloud service provider is willing to talk about how they can handle the breach and how your data is managed, where it is located, then that's the trusted cloud service provider. Next is virtual private network. That is, your users or employees can access the cloud across public network, home network, office network. So service providers or organizations should provide a secure remote access solution to the end users. So here we have SSL and VPN. That is the secure socket layer and the virtual private network. It can be used with standard web browsers. SSL protocol manages the secure message transmission on the internet. So it's the responsibility of the cloud service providers or organizations provide a secure remote access to the end users. Next is key management. Here, remote services would be cryptographically protected. Done. And cloud storage should be protected cryptographically. We have different keys on the server, like transport keys, authentication keys for the user authentication, and this one is for the transfer of the user information, file encryption keys, hardware storage keys, and certificates. Next is data security and management, that is securing of data in the cloud. Here in this case, cloud service provider must ensure the privacy and the security of the user data. In this case, we have different areas related to privacy and security of data, like where your data is stored geographically, that is the location of your data. Next is control of your data. Make sure your data can be trusted, that is integrity, its reliability, its confidentiality, and safe transfer of data, that is no leakage during transmission, and it should be encrypted. And in order to protect sensitive data from various attacks and hackers, security risks include, as we know, integrity, data integrity, data reliability, and confidentiality, and information should be protected. And billing risk, it means only pay for those resources that you consume. So you are billed correctly or not, you are billed correctly and only for the resources that you consume. So they have different security risk. Next is infrastructure security in the application level. In this case, it is the responsibility of the cloud service provider to manage end user security applications, like on the infrastructure, software, and platform. So that should be secure, and the application deployed by the users also need to be secured. So that's all about this security. So what we did, first we have different types of clients. Now clients means different ways to interact with the data and applications. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching.